So my novel is about a family of four, and when the book begins, we see them, all four of them, in the car driving on holiday. I am a member of a family of four, and I've had that experience of being in the car with my two children in the back seat driving out on vacation. And so when I'm writing in that moment, I'm writing something that feels really familiar to me. And there's something about the everyday, you know, a writer can take the everyday and reveal something much bigger. In the United States, a lot of times we use this term domestic fiction to talk about literature about the family. And domestic fiction, I think in the minds of some critics, can sound very small. It can sound like it's just about family life. But in my opinion, domestic fiction can be so big and can reveal so much. If you take a writer like Alice Munro, she writes domestic fiction about people having tea or quiet moments at home, but her stories, as the Nobel Prize has ratified, are huge, and they're about history and war and memory and time. And so I think the domestic can reveal something really big and important for every reader. So I live in Brooklyn with my family, right in the city. And I've spent, at this point, 20 years living in the city. And every summer, we go on holiday out to the beach. And I've realized about myself that that experience of nature is a little unsettling to me. It's too quiet. At night, it's too dark. And I'm so accustomed to ambient city light and ambient city noise. And when you're out in the country, you can feel very alone. And it can be a moment that's very peaceful, where you hear bird song and you see deer and you're having a sort of quiet experience of nature. But it can also be unsettling. And I think in this book, I wanted it to feel that tension of peace and tranquility bleeding into something a little unsettling. I think that the book is connected to a larger body of literature that takes two different kinds of people and puts them together and watches those sparks, and that becomes the story. And so I was thinking a lot about cinema, actually. I was thinking about hallmarks of theatrical works like Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf, where you have these two couples and they're quite different. One is older, one is younger, one is sort of combative and one is sort of in love. And the collision between those two families becomes the engine of the plot. And so in this book, it's that collision of a younger kind of upper middle class family life encountering an older couple who are black instead of white and very rich. And so those differences become the spark that becomes the plot.